This material is intended for general informational purposes only and does not constitute legal advice. The law varies by jurisdiction and is constantly changing. For legal advice, you should consult a lawyer that can apply the appropriate law to the facts in your case. Aloha, I'm Coralie Chun Matayoshi, and welcome to my legal podcast, What's the Law? Each week, you will learn valuable information about various legal topics to help you get through life's ups and downs, and even when things go sideways. So stay tuned. Now with me, I have David Louie. He's an attorney with the law firm of Kobayashi, Sugita, and Gota. He's previously served as the Attorney General for the State of Hawaii and President of the Hawaii State Bar Association. His practice focuses on complex commercial and construction defect litigation, general liability insurance defense, including catastrophic injuries, government relations, and procurement. Welcome, David.
Hi, Coralie. Thanks for having me on the show.
Great to have you. So Hawaii people love to gamble. We don't call Las Vegas the ninth island for nothing. So there's lots of different forms of gambling, from blackjack at casinos to state lotteries to fantasy football. What's the definition of gambling?
So gambling is doing something where you're staking or risking something of value on the outcome of a contest of chance or something that's a contingent event in the future in order to get something of value. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's illegal under Hawaii state law, not supposed to do it. Gambling is a misdemeanor that's punishable by a year in prison or up to $2,000 in a fine. And if you promote gambling, it's even more serious. That's a Class C felony that is punishable by 5 years in prison or up to $10,000 in a fine.
Wow. So Hawaii has some of the strictest gambling laws in the nation. Is any kind of gambling allowed?
Well, yeah, Hawaii is very strict and has always traditionally been strict. You know, any kind of casinos or sports betting, roulette, video poker, anything like that is illegal. The only thing that's allowed is social gambling, which means you could gamble with friends. You could go over to your friend's house and participate in a poker game or do something like that. But the key in social gambling is it has to take place in a private residence. Nobody can be the house. Nobody can make money off the deal.
Off of your friend.
Yeah. I mean, your friends might get something, but nobody can be doing it as a professional. And so you can't do it in a business establishment. You can't do it in a bar, nightclub, hotel, or restaurant. And no one can be below the age of majority. So you got to be careful about that. But social gambling is allowed.
So why is Hawaii so strict against gambling?
You know, that's an interesting question. Hawaii, in some ways, is very liberal socially, very permissive in some ways, but in other ways is very conservative. And gambling is just one of those things that we here in Hawaii have been very conservative about. The Roman Catholic Church has been very strong against gambling. The legislature has been very strong against gambling. There have been some very powerful moneyed interests that have wanted to promote gambling and establish casinos or establish gambling in hotels, but that's always been beaten back. Recently, gambling came up before this last legislative session in order to try and raise money for Native Hawaiian housing. But even that did not get traction in the legislature.
So what about fantasy football or March Madness office pools? Does it matter where it's done, whether it's a private or public office?
Well, you know, that's the funny thing. And generally, fantasy football pools or March Madness pools, which are the normal kind of things that happen, a small group of people, friends, nobody's the host, nobody's the house or anything like that. And people have their own teams and they wager relatively small amounts of money. That's considered social gambling and that's allowed. So things like fan duels or online kinds of gambling, such as DraftKings that bet on sports, those are not allowed because typically those are every day. They allow thousands of dollars to be wagered. The platform exists as the house and takes a cut of what's going on. So that's gambling. And the Attorney General in the state of Hawaii has even issued an opinion saying that fantasy sports, when it's done on these professional online platforms, is considered gambling and is illegal.
44 states have government-sponsored lotteries where you can win millions of dollars. And the federal law also allows states to participate in national lottery pools like Powerball, as well as multi-state contests. Hawaii doesn't have a state lottery. What if I go to the mainland on a trip and buy a ticket from another state? Is that legal?
You're fine. That's legal because, that's, you know, remember that saying, what happens in Vegas State you can go to Vegas and you can gamble and it's perfectly fine. You can go to California and buy a lottery ticket and it's perfectly fine because you're doing that outside of Hawaii. However, those lotteries cannot sell tickets here in Hawaii, even online. That would be illegal. They can't sell it here. That would be promoting gambling. So you can do it over there. You just can't do it here.
Okay, that's good. So we talked about social gambling and state lotteries and online gambling. What about charity raffles where you purchase tickets to win a prize drawing? Does it matter if you just make a donation instead of paying for the ticket? Or if you go to a dinner and everyone gets a raffle ticket without paying anything extra, what's allowed?
So charity raffles are sort of an interesting, close to the line creature because a raffle is technically a lottery, which is prohibited. Anytime you pay money for a chance to win something, that's a lottery and that's gambling. The way the law has defined that, however, is just that charity raffles can be legal as long as they follow the rules. And they say those rules are very clear. You cannot force somebody to pay for a ticket. Now, in practice, many people do think that they have to buy tickets, but that's why they call them donations. And so technically, you're not supposed to be able to, you know, force somebody to buy the chance. So they make a donation and you give them a certain number of tickets. So it's kind of skirting the line. But if you go to a charity dinner and if everybody gets a bingo ticket or a raffle ticket without paying for it, then that would be fine. And generally in practice, nobody really wants to go clamp down on the charity
right,
or the nonprofits.
You wouldn't be very popular.
No, not at all.
So what about sometimes radio stations have prize drawings, or everyone's heard about the publisher's clearinghouse sweepstakes where you can win big bucks. Is that okay as long as there's no purchase necessary to win?
Right. As long as there's no purchase necessary to win, as long as it's a donation, as long as you're not giving something of value or you're getting, you know, in order to get something of value, then that's okay. Well, you know, when I was Attorney General, I had a funny episode involving Daniel Dae Kim, who's the superstar actor on Hawaii Five-0. Daniel had offered on Facebook to all of his followers that they could win a chance to be on the Hawaii Five-0 set if they would send him a picture of them voting in the voting booth, because he wanted to promote voting.
Right.
And that was really a great civic kind of a thing for him to do. But the problem was the deputy attorneys general let me know, oh, he can't do that. It's illegal under the law. And the problem wasn't the gambling laws, which we called them up, and his people, his publicist said, no, our lawyers looked at this, it's legal. And we said, well, the problem is not the gambling laws, because he wasn't having anybody pay for it. The problem was the voting laws. Mm-hmm. The voting laws said that you can't give anybody anything of value to vote or not vote. And since he was encouraging people to vote and he was offering them this chance, then that was a problem. So I actually happened to call up Daniel, who was a really gracious man and really smart. He went to law school before he became a superstar actor. And he got it very quickly. And then he graciously walked it back. But that was an interesting episode.
So the recent lotteries conducted by the state and entities like Kaiser to encourage vaccinations, that's okay because they're not giving anything of value to receive the vaccinations, right? It's legal. It's not gambling.
It's not gambling. It's legal. It's okay, because everybody who gets a vaccination shot is entered into the opportunity to win something. So, and nothing's being paid of value.
So now let's talk about some more serious offenses, including organized gambling. There's a lot of game rooms popping up in neighborhoods and commercial properties. What happens if people get busted for that?
Well, they can be convicted of gambling, which is a misdemeanor. And the people who are promoting these video game parlors or games can be convicted of promoting gambling, which is a serious Class C felony. Mm-hmm. So those are problematic to participate in organized gambling and the video game parlors and things like that. Yes.
And what about cockfighting? That's pretty widespread in Hawaii. It's not only the betting, and not to mention cruelty to animals, but raising cockfighting chickens to be sold in places like Guam. What's the scoop on that?
Well, you know, cockfighting is illegal, both because it's cruelty to animals and because it involves gambling. So it's got two strikes against it. But yes, culturally, it's been promoted, you know, in some cultures throughout the Pacific region, and people have done it, and so it is widespread, but it is illegal. I had an interesting episode when I was a young lawyer. A guy shipped a whole bunch of fighting chickens to Hilo in a container to sell them, but they all died. They got overheated and they died, and so he made a claim, and I was representing the insurance company. He wanted $250 a bird. Because they were fighting chickens, and they were quite valuable to him. We gave him $2.50 a pound because they were just chickens, and couldn't prove that they were particularly valuable without admitting that he was engaged in illegal behavior. He was not a happy camper.
But at least he wasn't in jail.
That's true.
And that's a wrap. I want to thank David Louie for his time and expertise. And thank you for joining us on What's the Law. Until next time, ahui ho.